Hey guys, it's Erica and welcome back to my channel. As you may notice, I am quite the bit blonder today. What started out as just a root touch-up session quickly turned into an all-over bleaching session just to kind of even up the length of my hair to my roots. And honey, my roots went so light. Look at this. I want my roots to be one or two shades darker. I would really like them to be like the color of this down here. If any of you know how to do that, because you know your girl is not a hairstylist. But I do bleach my own hair. So honey, if you have any ideas for me on how to just darken the roots a shade or two, please let me know down below, okay? So anyways, today I wanted to come to you with a little bit of a haul. I have been buying quite a bit of stuff here lately, okay? But mainly, it's all drugstore. Y'all know I love my drugstore beauty stuff as much as I love the high end. So let's go ahead and jump on into it because my videos are so long that I sit down in front of the camera and talk to like this. And I don't want to have to edit an hour of footage, okay? But I'm probably going to have to. This isn't a review type video. This is simply a haul. But some of this stuff I have used, so I will tell you a little bit of how I like it as the video goes, okay? Got me a little cup of coffee here, honey. This was in my favorites video, the Minion mug. I did get this from Universal Studios, for those of you who want to know, but I did find several on eBay. So if you just type in Universal Studios Minion mug, it will pop up. That being said, I also am going to be mentioning a couple of things in this video because they are new to my collection that I've recently purchased, but they were in fact in my favorites video. So I will tell you whenever I get to those products, but I'm not going to spend a ton of time on this stuff. I'll link that video down below. I'll talk about them a little bit more there. So the most exciting thing I guess I've got to talk to you about today, these new eyeshadows from L'Oreal. Have you all seen these? These are the Infallible Paints Metallics. These are fabulous. I am wearing a mixture of this one. This is the one in Caged. This is probably my favorite. It's just a really pretty kind of bronzy taupe color. There you go. Look at this. I want to show you a swatch. I mean, guys, look at that. And I did top it a little bit with this brass knuckles shade today because I knew I was going to be wearing a lot of gold, okay? So I did just top that caged color with brass knuckles. What? Look at this one. This is probably the most impressive one out of the collection. This is aluminum foil. And honey, what does it look like? Aluminum foil. Look at that, guy. That is the most intense silver eyeshadow of life. And then I have this last one that I got in rose chrome. Okay. They only have 5 shades in this line. The other one was like a purple and I did pass on that, like a lilac, I guess, because I just have so many purple shadows, but I thought I would use all of these. I'm going to do a little bit of a swatch fest here. Look at that, aluminum foil. That is brass knuckles, caged, and what is that one called? Rose chrome. Guys, love these. Can you see how marvelous? So y'all know I have oily skin with very large pores, and something that I've really been getting into are blur sticks, okay? I mentioned this one in my favorites video. This is the Milk Makeup Blur Stick. I was introduced to this through the Sephora Playbox subscription. They sent out like a little mini tube of this. It works so well. So what did I do, honey? I placed me an order on Ulta, and I did get the Catrice Prime and Fine Anti-Shine Blur Stick. I don't find this to be really anti-shine at all. I am wearing it today. Today was the first time that I've ever used this. I think that it is good at blurring your pores. So I definitely like this one so far better than this one, but definitely a huge price difference in those two. Kind of staying on the whole face makeup thing, I have one new foundation. Y'all know I don't buy a whole lot of new foundations because I really stick to what works for me. I'm very oily and things just don't work for me like they do the general public, right? But guys, I've been loving this. The Maybelline Superstay Better Skin Foundation. I have mine in the shade Nude Beige 25, okay? This is a really good color match for me. I'm wearing it today. I will say it's not extremely matte, but it's not dewy either. I think it's just a really natural satin finish. It covers well, covers what I need it to, honey. I don't go for cake face, really. I like things to look a little bit more natural. I don't care if freckles or whatever pop through, but this covers so well, and great, great drugstore foundation. So far, so good. In the past couple of weeks, I have also picked up two new setting sprays from the drugstore, the Milani Make It Last and the Catrice Prime and Fine Multi-Talent Fixing Spray.
Okay.
Again, the Catrice I got from Ulta. I got the Milani at my local Meijer or drugstore. I took the Milani to Florida, and like me and my mom both used it. I put quite a dent in this. Me and my mom both used it in Florida, and like I would use it every time I had the chance of the morning before we went to like the theme parks. When we got back in and we were getting ready to go to dinner, like I used it all the time. I love it. I'm using the Catrice one today. It's the first time that I used it. Both of these are very travel friendly, as they're in little plastic bottles with little plastic caps. So far, I really, really love these. Another item that ended up in my favorites this month is the e.l.f. Aqua Beauty Blush and Bronzer Duo in the shade Bronzed Violet. I have since went back to Target, honey, and picked up the shade Bronzed Peach, and I am wearing this one today, and it is beautiful. You're probably aware of the kind of classic blush and bronzer duos from e.l.f., the powder ones. These are a gorgeous, a cream formula. How pretty. I'll swatch them for you. Bronzed Violet with its bronzer. And then Bronzed Peach with its bronzer. Okay, so that's what those look like. There is a third color in this line, and it is called Pink Beige. But honestly, I'm just so happy with these two. I don't even want the other one. Out of the two, my favorite is probably the Bronzed Violet. And then I think the only other product that made it into my favorites video that I'm going to mention in this video is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder in the Sweetest Bling. This is limited edition. It is still available on their site. I checked just as of yesterday, it was still on there. And I think this was around $4.99. Super affordable, just a gorgeous, creamy highlight with that wonderful pinky tint. One of my favorite highlight shades of life. Let's swatch this one here. I mean, just so pretty. I did pick up the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise Mascara. This is, let me move this big box down, honey. Good Lord. This mascara is very similar to the Too Faced Better Than Sex, okay? The Too Faced Better Than Sex is one of my holy grail mascaras. My favorite way to use it is as a second mascara on the upper lashes. I know, I'm a little over the top, but it works so good, like, as a second coat, because it just really separates and lengthens, and it gets out any clumps. So good. If you've not tried it like that, you need to. But look at these wands. They are very similar. The Too Faced Better Than Sex wand is very distinct. It has a very distinct kind of hourglass shape, okay? So you definitely have the same thing going on in the L'Oreal one. The only difference really that you really notice is the Too Faced Better Than Sex wand is very, very heavy. There's a definite weight to that wand, whereas the L'Oreal one is very light. But I'm using this mascara for the first time today. I bought it back before I went on vacation, but I've just not been wearing a whole lot of makeup. I think it did a really pretty job of lengthening and separating. I did use it as a second mascara today. I first did a coat of the Essence Lash Princess. I love doing my mascara like that. And then I did use the L'Oreal as a second step mascara. So far so good on that one. So my favorite nail polish of life, honey, is I'm Addicted by Essie. Gorgeous aquamarine. You know, blue nail polishes are my favorite. Like, there's just something about them. They make me happy. They truly do. And I don't think it gets any better than I'm Addicted. I left the cap off, like totally unscrewed completely like that. and didn't even realize it. And the only bottle that I had left of it, this is one of the only nail polishes that I've actually emptied 2 or 3 bottles. Totally. Really? When I left the cap off, this was totally hardened, like down here. And when you would turn it up, it didn't move. Like, it stayed in a ball at the bottom, okay? I have since used my Beauty Secrets nail polish thinner from Sally Beauty Supply. And I think that I have got it to where you can actually use it. It's a little goopy, so it was a little worrisome that this would be my only bottle of it. Honey, I picked me up another bottle, fresh bottle, from eBay. Had to pay about $15 for it. But guys, get you a bottle of this while you can. I guess it was like limited edition or whatever, and you can't find this everywhere. So I'm so happy to have a fresh bottle in my collection. Hopefully that other bottle that I kind of worked on will work too. But love I'm Addicted by Essie. Cannot wait to use this again. Another polish that I picked up this month is Reggae to Riches by China Glaze. I don't know if the color is really going to show on camera, but this isn't just a purple polish. This polish has a blue shift to it, kind of in the light. And then I have one more polish. I actually went to Ulta today because I actually picked up another nail polish today. And it is the ever popular OPI Funny Bunny. I feel like everybody talks about Funny Bunny, right? White nail polishes are one of my favorite colors to wear. This isn't like a stark white. It's more of a soft white. It actually really reminds me of Essie Marshmallow, if you all have that one. But I'll probably put this on my nails tonight. So excited to try that. The only other thing that I got from Ulta today was this brand new Philosophy Pore Extractor Mask. Had y'all seen this? I hear wonderful things about it. So as someone with very oily skin, I constantly have a problem with blackheads. I can't wait to try this, honey, because as you know, pores just fill back in and you're constantly having to like do something to empty them out, right? I think I might actually do a video on this tonight whenever I take my makeup off. That's what I'll do. This is expensive though. I think this was like either $35 or $37, something like that. I think online you can actually get a travel size to try out, but there in the store today, all they had was this Big Daddy one. So that's what I got. Oh yeah, I forgot to show you this. The other day whenever I placed that first order with Ulta and got like the L'Oreal eyeshadows and that other stuff, L'Oreal had a gift with purchase and it was just this little like, I guess, cosmetic bag. And they have some samples in here. So they're Everpure Sulfate Free Shampoo and Conditioner. I actually really like that. A coupon for the L'Oreal Infallible Paints. Is this also a, yeah, it's also a sample. So I should have used that today. I didn't even know it was a sample, really, to be honest. And then a sample of the Hydrogenious Daily Liquid Care Glow Finish. I don't really do glow things because I glow from just the oil in my skin. A little more samples here. And then I'll show you just some of the hair stuff that I have picked up. Y'all know I color my hair at home, obviously. Well, honey, I found this new developer. Okay, 30 volume developer. And it is by Redken. It's the Blonde Icing Blonde Idol Conditioning Cream Developer. This, doing my hair this time and getting it this light, this is what I used, okay? I don't know how I feel about it. Like, my hair feels great. It really does. It's silky. It doesn't feel damaged or anything. This is just so thick, okay? And it does say on here that it was designed to be used with the Redken Blonde Icing Conditioning Cream Lightener. So, a cream lightener. I used the Wella Powder Lightener. But, you know, everything says, even on the Wella, it says to use the Wella developer with it. So I just figure, heck, developer's developer. I just used it with the powder lightener, okay? Let's see what that was. Something about Poshmark, honey. But anyways, I just went ahead and mixed it with the powder lightener. That stuff is so thick, that developer. And so when you put it on your hair, it's white. Really, really white because it's so thick. Well, you can't really judge how light your hair's getting because that is, it's white as soon as you put it on there, okay? So, I think it's a good product. It's just so thick. It's hard to tell where your hair's at. So like twice while it was on my hair, I had to rinse a little section of my hair off under the faucet to see where I was at. And I was shocked to see just how dark it was still, because it looked snow white with this on it. So I don't know. I did buy me some more Olaplex, because I use this like it's going out of style. That's how I keep the health in my hair. I'm going to have to speed through this video because the light is going to make me look weird, right? Like every time I fill up my bowl with bleach and lightener, I use a fourth of an ounce of this. So you'll go through quite a bit whenever you're bleaching your hair, because I got a ton of hair to bleach, honey. The little box of Olaplex that I got this time had one bottle of the step one and two bottles of the step two, which actually works out great for me because this I end up using more of. And then the last thing that I got right now at Sally Beauty Supply, they have their Wella toners on sale. Buy one, get one free. My videos are so professional, ain't they? So I bought four of these and I only use one at a time. So I've already got three in my backup for whenever I bleach my hair coming up, okay? It is so hot up here. Look at that highlight though. If y'all are wondering what it is, I never use this highlight, but I am using it today because I'm wearing so much gold, okay? I got the little gold pineapples in my shirt. It's the Laura Geller Gilded Honey. It's the gold highlight. I mean, it's okay. It's never one that I reach for, just to be honest. So the last stuff that I have here to talk about today are skincare related. Wayne Goss talks about this, the Ordinary stuff, all the time. But this is the Caffeine Solution 5% EGCG. But the Ordinary is a skincare line. There's like a high-end Ordinary line and then a more affordable version of the Ordinary. And this is from the more affordable line. This was, I don't even remember how much, maybe $5 or $10, if that. And I want to say I got this from ASOS. I'll have to look and see. I don't really remember. But all it says on here is just massage a small amount onto the eye contour AM and PM. I've not really got to use this yet, but it is caffeine and it reduces the appearance of eye contour, pigmentation, and of puffiness, okay? Wayne Goss went on and on and on about this, so I'm going to have to give it a whirl. www.ordinaries.com. It says it's the website here on the bottle. Focus! There. And so the last products that I have to talk about are all by the brand Palmer's. I think we all know Palmer's from their cocoa butter, right? But Palmer's actually has a lot of products if you actually look at all the products in the line. And first one that caught my eye was this new Palmer's cocoa butter formula with vitamin E, skin therapy cleansing oil for the face, okay? I got this at Meijer. I don't know how new it is, but I love removing my makeup with a cleansing oil. My favorite is probably the MAC Cleanse Off Oil. But this is nice. It has a nice rose hip fragrance, which if you watched one of my favorites videos, I guess from last month, honey, I love the skin therapy oil for face with vitamin E. This has a rose hip scent as well. It smells so good. This has every kind of good oil for your skin in it that you can imagine. One of my very favorite facial oils. But this cleanse off oil, I do think that it does do good. I've used it just a few times, honey. But I probably still prefer the MAC cleanse off oil, but this is so much cheaper and more readily available. So I'll probably just continue to buy this one, honey, to be honest. I know there's a lot of controversy around using hydroquinone in your skincare products. Hydroquinone lightens the skin. But I have a few areas that I would like to lighten, honey. And one is just kind of like a little scar on my shoulder. I had a spider bite not long ago. I don't know if I even mentioned that on YouTube, but I know I did on Snapchat. That was so painful. And it's just left a little dark area that's slow to heal. And then I've also noticed, I noticed it on my Chicago vlogs with David. When I would turn my head, I've really got some dark pigmentation here. I mean, your girl ain't a spring chicken no more. I'm 38. So I just wanted to get something that would hopefully lighten those areas. And that's when I found the Palmer's Skin Success Anti-Dark Spot Fade Milk. This is now with retinol. It brightens skin, balances tone, fades dark spots, corrects discoloration, and deeply moisturizes with alpha hydroxy, vitamin C, E, and sunscreen. This is 2% hydroquinone. Okay, that's kind of hard to find in over-the-counter skincare. Hydroquinone is usually prescription, okay? So this is actually working really well. I use just the tiniest amount, and I've only had it for a few days, honey. But I am putting it here and on this little spot, and I swear this spot on my shoulder is basically about gone. So, I got a hair on my face. I got a hair. Look how oily. It's hot in here. So the last product that I have to talk to you about is the Palmer's Bust Cream, okay? And as you can see, yes, this is made for the chest, okay? It says, firms and tones skin around the bust area. That is not why I bought this. This is basically just shea butter, collagen, and elastin. Well, it says on here, too, that you can help reduce the appearance of stretch marks. It's paraben-free, phthalate-free, dermatologist-tested. I didn't buy this to firm and tone the skin around my bust area. I bought this because of a video that I found on YouTube. There's a hair on my face, and it's itching me to death. But anyways, I'll have to look up her name. I'll put it here. She has so many good videos about skincare. But she said that she uses this bust cream on her upper eyelid, kind of like as an upper eyelid eye cream. Because as you know, a lot of your eye creams are not made to go on the upper eyelid, okay? That's a very sensitive area. And as someone who has extremely sensitive eyes, I can't use even what most people can use on their upper eyelid. Oils are out of the question because as they warm up, they can run into your eye. I can't risk anything getting in my eyes because I have the world's most sensitive eyes, truly. And like, there was an eye cream I got a couple years ago. I can't even remember what, but it specifically said on there to pat on the upper eyelid, around the eye, under the eye, and out to the temple. I got chemical burns on my eyeballs, my actual eyeballs. Like when I would look down, the whole top part of my eyeball was a chemical burn. Like I'm so sensitive. So I have to neglect that area a lot in my skincare simply because I can't handle the irritation. This doesn't irritate it at all. And I've really noticed some firming action going on. My eyes are not hooded. You know your eyelid is hooded when you look at somebody head on and you don't see any of their eyelid. You actually do see my eyelid. I guess they're partially hooded out here. But guys, totally firming up that area. But it just feels so good to have something that doesn't irritate my super crazy sensitive eyes. But I think that does it for my haul. Hopefully. But basically, this is what I have purchased in the last couple of weeks, okay? Let me know if you have bought any of these things and what you think about them. Let me know what your favorite Infallible Paints Metallics eyeshadow is. And let me know if you've ever tried I'm Addicted, because that is the best polish of life. So let me know if there's anything you recommend for me to pick up and try that you've been loving. And guys, I will see you in my next video.